Hi, Taurus. It's Sloane Rhodes here with your life purpose tarot reading for July, August, and September 2016. I'm going to be drawing one card from the fairy tarot, looking at the general energies around your life purpose during this time period, three cards from the life purpose oracle deck, and one card from the money and the law of attraction oracle deck, and another one from the magical unicorns oracle deck. I'm going to go ahead and just pull the cards and get started with your reading, Taurus. Okay, the hermit dropped out. I feel like I want to pull one more. And the dreamer, two major arcana cards. Gosh, Aries has had two major arcana cards come out as well for their reading. All right, let me get three from the life purpose oracle deck. Then let me get one more from the money and the law of attraction. I am the attractor of my every experience. More from the magical unicorns for you, Taurus. Okay, here we go. Just be yourself. I love it. It goes with the dreamer energy here at the top. Okay, let me just take in these energies for you, Taurus, and then I'll start your reading. Again, this is for your life purpose. And I know many of you have heard me say this before, but your life purpose is never something that you need to seek outside of yourself. Your life purpose is something that is revealed from within, each and every moment, really, with the thoughts that you think and the actions that you take. But it does take practice and consciousness around it, but the more that you can create some consciousness around your what you're doing in every moment in the way that you think and the things that you do, you can begin to take more control of your life and reveal your life purpose more consciously in every moment, which leads to more and more abundance within your life. So that's just a gentle reminder for you, Taurus. Well, I do see with the hermit energy that there is going to be, for some of you, a strong desire to take some time out it's almost as if I feel like you're just kind of, maybe you've been tired, maybe you've been working hard on something, but whatever it is, it's kind of drawing you to a period where you are going within a bit more. Maybe you're seeking a little bit of spiritual insight within self during this time period. But whatever it is, I also feel like for some of you it will manifest as being a mentor for others, helping others in some way, providing a light. I'm really drawn to the lantern, providing a light for others. But you're going to have to do a little bit of quietude within self first. And I see that going with this study card right in the center here, as well as you take some time to just be with yourself for a while. You know, it's one thing to take action when we feel inspired, but when we take action from a place where we feel fatigued, we're really working against the energies that are available to us. So it's okay to feel this way, Taurus, and allow it to just kind of be as it is. And when you do feel action, and for some of you, you certainly will, because we have the dreamer energy, which is an absolute leap of faith upon a new journey. again, this is during a 3-month time period, so you know, it's not surprising that we would have two different energies coming in here. But the dreamer energy is a new beginning, and I feel like after you take this time out period, you do feel re-energized and invigorated, and you take that leap of faith, and you embark upon something new regarding your life purpose. The way in which you see yourself has been probably altered a little bit as you take time out to kind of transform parts of yourself as you move forward, Taurus. And then it's so pretty here with the Life Purpose Oracle decks. We have the flowers card. And so for some of you, it does indicate that there is part of your life purpose will involve possibly gardening or being a florist, you know, very, very clear message for some of you, but not for everyone, obviously. It says working with flowers opens your heart and brings blessing to others through your life purpose. But what I also see here for you, Taurus, is being out in nature, just taking time to smell the roses, so to speak. It feels like goes very beautifully with this hermit energy. There's a very gentle feeling about this. For some of you, I feel like it will involve helping others who are ill. I don't know, I just get the feeling this is kind of like a an incarnated angel at the side of people who are either in a nursing home, elderly, or ill people. I just feel that very strongly for some of you, Taurus. And then right in the center of this reading, we do have the study card, and the text of this card, Taurus, says, reading, research, and education help you gain confidence and clarity about your career. But I am really drawn to this timer here, the sands of time going through, and I feel like there's a part of you that is aware that time is running out, so to speak, and I feel like it kind of goes with this hermit card, like you're allowing yourself this time out, but then you know that the dreamer energy is about to come, so I feel like you know that this time is limited. Something about time here for you is what I'm really, really drawn to. And I feel like during this time period, it's going with that hermit energy. You're just taking time to do a little research to understand yourself better, or even the steps you might need to take within your actual career. You do have the key, though. I'm really drawn to the key around his neck. I don't know if you can see it, but you have everything it takes to unlock that key within yourself regarding your life purpose during this time. But you're taking a little bit of time. I'm really getting that word time very strongly. It's almost as if you know that you have these months, a certain period of time within these months, it's almost like you scheduled it. Of course, you're Taurus, you're very practical, you're Earth sign. And it's like, I've scheduled this time to be still and reflect, and then I'm going to, and study and you know, educate myself, and then I'm going to move on. It's almost like that. It's almost like you're intuiting that this great leap of faith is coming for you. So it may be that you do have something planned already, and you're allowing yourself a little bit of decompression time before you begin again. Then we have to talk to your angels. Instead of worrying, ask for divine guidance. And it kind of feels like it goes very strongly with this. I am the attractor of my every experience. Like, you know, don't do your best not to give in to thoughts around worrying, because it's very self-defeating. And that you tend to, you know, if you subscribe to the law of attraction, it does, you know, that theory is that you do attract more and more of the negative when you're constantly worrying. It's not a very productive exercise. So instead of worrying, a practical piece of advice for you, Taurus, would be to, if you find yourself saying, oh gosh, you know, I wonder how I'm going to do that, instead of saying, I wonder how, you can say, you know, please guide me, you know, to your guides and angels. It's just a little tweak of it, but it turns it away from being kind of victim-y and more proactive, and knowing that you're supported always, so you don't feel as tossed around by external circumstances. And then just be yourself is such a beautiful card. It says you're a great person, enjoy being yourself. And I really feel like it goes so beautifully with this dreamer energy. You know, she's so happy-go-lucky, this little fairy, and she's just ready to go, and she's just being herself, and she doesn't really care what anyone else thinks, because she's taken that act. You know, she's taken that leap of faith through her courage. And I feel like just be yourself, Taurus. You know, it's okay. You're a lovely, lovely human. Lovely soul, and you deserve all the abundance that you are seeking. Just, you know, try not to worry so much, because it's all here available for you. And I really do feel like, you know, the more that you're sort of kind and gentle with yourself as well, is very, very strongly indicated as being extremely beneficial to you right now. Let me get one more card, then I'm going to close out your reading, Taurus. from the Magical Fairies Oracle deck. Pregnancy. The birth of a child brings great blessings to you and the world. Well, that would certainly explain for some of you why you're in the hermit mode. Again, that's the number nine, and it's 9 months. As you're building, you're growing something, so that really does feel right and true for some of you. And it also just means, again, with the hermit and the nine, that it's symbolically you are taking that time out in order to grow something so that you can go on that leap of faith, right, with that dreamer energy. Because when that child comes out, it's a whole new beginning, and it kind of feels like that's happening for you during this time period, Taurus. Like you're taking those 9 months, so to speak, out so that you can be that hermit, because you are changing and transforming and growing. But no matter what happens, and you're doing the research, and either on yourself or regarding your career, and you're being gentle with yourself as you would with someone who is growing a baby. And whatever happens in the end, however you feel after you've had this period of being the hermit and the period of study and the time out, when you're ready to act upon everything that you've learned, have the confidence to just be yourself and be the beautiful soul that you are, because that's going to stand you in good stead as you move forward. And again, that you are the attractor of your every experience, so you want to attract things that you desire. So try to spend as much time as you can in a place of focusing on the things that you are excited about, as opposed to the things that you are scared or nervous about. All right, Taurus, there's your reading. I hope you found it helpful. I wish you much love, and I will see you on the next video or at your private reading. Till then.